Something you'll hear often in the world of espresso, especially from us, is that your choice of espresso grinder will have a far greater impact on your shots than your choice of espresso machine. Even once you've come around to that axiom, choosing a grinder can still be a challenge. Today, I'm going to break down the different parts of a grinder and which ones will make the most meaningful difference in your shots so you can pick the right grinder for you. First, let's look at something that comes up a lot when talking about grinders, burrs. This is a pair of grinding edges that cuts your coffee down to a specific size. The size is adjusted simply by changing the distance between these two pieces. There are two main styles of burrs, flat and conical. They're generally regarded as producing slightly different flavor profiles. This is difficult to quantify, but it essentially comes down to how the different designs cut up the coffee. You'll often hear people refer to flat burrs as producing a smooth, well-rounded flavor profile, where conical burrs produce more of a punchy profile, with notes standing out more individually and holding up better to milk. Generally speaking, this is true, though the difference can be really subtle. Even around our office, we sometimes guess incorrectly when we subject each other to blind taste tests. This isn't an organized practice, it's just our idea of fun. Both conical and flat burrs gain a couple key benefits from increased size. First, the increased cutting surface area means that you will get grinds of a more consistent size. The peak of this increased consistency from burr size is somewhere between 60 and 75 millimeters. For reference, most coffee shops use burrs between 75 and 85 millimeters in diameter. The other key benefit is heat management. Smaller burrs have to spin more quickly to grind coffee in a reasonable time, where larger burrs can spin slowly and also have more thermal mass to dissipate heat. By imparting less heat onto the grounds before brewing, you preserve more flavor. Motor power is another significant factor, but you'll find that in any good grinder, it scales pretty closely with burr size. This is because to turn larger burrs, which are crushing more beans at once, you need more torque to overcome the resistance. That extra torque also allows you to grind at a lower RPM, which reduces the heat generated by friction and also reduces the likelihood of a jam. The last key detail is how you intend to use your grinder. Do you plan to use it with a full hopper or by single dosing? Both methods have their benefits, but if you hope to single dose with a grinder, you're going to need one that doesn't build up a lot of ground coffee inside. We call this grind retention. If you plan on filling up your hopper for the speed and convenience, then you won't have to think too much about this, but if you intend to single dose, then I highly recommend watching our single dose and comparison video linked below. In the end, you should always organize your budget to prioritize a great grinder first and a great espresso machine second. A great machine can have all kinds of benefits in terms of speed, convenience, and build quality, but in the end, a great grinder is what determines how good your espresso will actually taste, which is what we're all here for. The closer you get to that 60 to 75 millimeter burr range, the better your espresso will be. Entry-level grinders like the Baratza Sette 270 have more modest specs and materials, but provide all the precision needed to pull really good shots. Grinders like the Eureka Mignon Specialita get close to that optimal burr size range, while also offering tons of benefits like low retention and super quiet operation. In the 60 to 75 millimeter range, there are plenty of excellent options, including the Eureka Atom 75, the Profitec T64, and the ECM V Titan, as well as many more. Each of these grinders offers their own unique benefits, but rest assured that they'll all enable you to pull some of the best shots you've ever had. If this video helped you get one step closer to choosing your perfect home espresso grinder, be sure to hit the like button. Have a specific machine or grinder comparison you'd like to see in a future video? Let me know in the comments below. For more coffee knowledge, tamp, subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.